Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to find the LCM or least common multiple of two numbers in Java. So let's get started. So first thing, we have to get input of two numbers from the user. So for this we'll be using the scanner class. So just go here and type import java.util.S. We'll be having scanner. Yeah, scanner class. Just import scanner class, don't import the whole util package. And after coming here, we will be creating a variable for the scanner class. It's going to be scanner input equal to new scanner, and within this we will be having system.in. So it's going to be capital S system.in. all right, and just come outside of that. And next thing, we'll be inputting two numbers from the user. So let's have a print statement. So I'll go with enter within double quotes, obviously, enter number one, some space, and next line it's going to be int n1 by number equal to input, that is our scanner variable dot next int. You need to use next int and not next line, because here it is an integer value and not a string value. So after having this print and next int statement, just copy this, because we need two numbers from the user, and you can just paste it in the next line. It's going to be number two, and here also n2. All right, so how I am going to find the LCM is, first we will be having an infinite while loop, it will be running forever. And after that, I will be having a variable named as LCM. So the value of that variable LCM will keep on get incremented and increasing till that particular LCM's value is divisible by both our number one and number two. So once that LCM's value is divisible by both these numbers, I will just break the condition so that the while loop terminates and we will be just printing the LCM's value. So first I will do this way, and later I will show you how you can optimize the number of iterations of this method. Okay, so as I told you, I'll be having an infinite loop. So for creating an infinite while loop, just put while true over here. And I also told you that I will be having a variable called as LCM. So let int LCM, let my initial value be equal to 1. All right, this is good now. And another thing that I told you is that we will repeat this process till LCM is divisible by both our numbers. So it's going to be if LCM mod n1 equal to 0, which is basically if the remainder is 0, it means that LCM is completely divisible by number 1. Okay, so that's the condition. Modulus operator returns the remainder, and if the remainder is 0, it means it's absolutely divisible by the number 1. So I'll just have an AND condition, because I need both the numbers to divide our LCM. And LCM modulus of number 2 equal to 0, right? So I'm having this condition, and if this condition is true, we will just break the loop, just terminate the while loop. And another thing what I told you is, I will just increment the value of LCM in each iteration. So LCM plus plus. So if LCM is 1 during the first iteration, it will be 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. It will just keep on going as the number of iterations goes on, because we are on an infinite loop. So after this, I will just have system out. This will just print the LCM. All right. So this is the simplest way. So for example, yeah, if you are still having down an LCM, LCM of 3 and 7 is 21, because that's like the smallest multiple, right? And LCM of 4 and 8 is 8, because 8 is divisible by both 4 and 8. So this is the point that we are making over here. So let me just now save it, and I hope this works. So I'll just come here, Java C to compile my program, and Java to view the output. So enter number 1, I will go with 3. Enter number 2, I'll go with 7. I'm getting 21 in the output. That is fine, and let me go with some other number 2. Enter number 1, I will go with 6, and I will go with 10. I think we need to get the output as 30, yeah? Because that's the number that is divisible by both of these at first. So I'm getting 30, so this method is working perfectly fine. So another small improvement that we can do to reduce the number of iterations of this program is not starting this LCM variable by one. So here you can say in this case we are starting from one and we are just incrementing it on each step. So there is like an additional waste of iterations because of this initializing of LCM value by one. So in this case, here you saw, right, for 4 and 8, the minimum LCM was the number, the second number itself, that is the largest number. So from this particular thing, we can conclude that the minimum LCM of any of the two numbers is going to be the largest number among the two. So for example, we had 4 and 8 as 8. So in that case, the minimum LCM is going to be 8. That is the largest number amongst the two numbers. So we can just begin our LCM value from the largest number of the two numbers that we are inputting. So here we can just have a ternary operator, okay? So to find the largest number, you can do it with the help of if statement also, but I will just use the ternary operator. It looks more clean. So N1, if N1 is greater than N2, which means that N1 is the largest number. So I will just assign N1's value. Or else, if this condition is false, then N2 is the largest number. That's it. Or else you can also do this. If N1 greater than N2, you can just have LCM equal to N1, and within the else block, LCM equal to N2. So this particular 6 lines of code is being simplified by one line with the help of ternary operator. So both are the same. Okay. And the other advantage is that now LCM is not starting from one, it is rather starting from the largest number itself. So in case, in this case, let's suppose take that 4 and 8 are the numbers, this particular code will finish off in one iteration itself, because we will be having LCM as 8, which is the largest number, 8 mod 4 equal to 0 and 8 mod 8 equal to 0. That's it, it will go off. But in case if our LCM value was 1, this needs to iterate like 8 times again till that our LCM value reaches 8. So I hope this made sense. This is like a super cool change in case if you're dealing with bigger numbers. So how use this condition, okay? Assign the largest number among the two to your LCM variable. And in case if you're having three numbers, you can just do this. You can just assign the largest value to this and you can just have another AND condition over here. Straightforward, that is. So let's see if this works. I'm compiling it again and running it. So this time I will go with the same 4 and 8 stuff. I'm getting 8 in the output, and I'll go with 10, and maybe this time I'll go with 3. So this time I need to get the output as 30. Yeah, I'm getting 30. So that's it, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done many Java tutorials, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Cloud Operations, Spring Boot. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.